Hey, yo, spark up the Phillies and pass the stout. Make it quick, money grip, hold your f***ers out. We got snow. Let's go. Okay, so the dogs are extremely excited, so I'm gonna go surprise them with some cookies.
Good morning, boys. Wanna come say hi? Come here. Good morning. Happy winter.
For Benny. For Murphy. The boys.
Alright, it's officially winter.
The dogs are very excited.
I got a lot to do today. I'm happy it's snowing. I feel like the anticipation for winter, like, sucks. But then, like, once it snows, it's like, look how beautiful this is. You know what I mean?
Oh, excuse me. Hi, I know what you're thinking. Patrick went Hollywood. He bought the Sony FX3, and he doesn't really care about the A6400 anymore. Well, I'm here to tell you that that's not true. Let's get into it. Is that good? I raised the question, is the Sony A6400 still worth it in the upcoming year, 2022? Short answer, yes, so if that's what you're looking for, peace out. Thank you for being here. But if you want to stick around for a couple reasons as to why I still use this every day and recommend it to new photographers and videographers, this video's for you. I'm joined with my sister. I kind of just wanted her to be in the video.
You did?
Yeah. So, reason number one, this camera still shoots 4K, 30, 24 frames per second, and full HD at 120 frames per second. The low light is good, and the quality of the footage is great. I've used it on professional shoots, and I still use it every day, even though I have the FX3 and the A7 III. Big reason is that it's just so convenient. It's nice and small, easy to carry around. I take it skateboarding with my friends. I shoot YouTube videos with it. It's still much part of the cycle of the cameras that I use.
I actually know a lot about cameras too. I took photography for 2 semesters.
In my last video, I talked about cropping in on footage for social media. And it's true in a sense. I guess my thought process for having a 4K slow motion shooting camera is that when you crop in, it's not going to be as much of a quality loss on 4K footage as it would be with this camera. However, with Instagram, they compress your videos no matter what camera you're shooting on. I swear some of my FX3 footage looks like it was shot on an iPhone. And that's not even my fault. I think it's Instagram's fault. So if you're just posting sports edits or skateboarding or, you know, traveling videos on your Instagram, you're still very much fine with this one. I'll do a little test right now. I'll show you this same shot just with the A6400. How does it look? Not that much different, in my opinion. I think we're talking about $3,200 price difference between the two cameras. Does it look like $3,200 of a difference to you? Maybe. Maybe not. But this is just some food for thought. Again, I'll show a bunch of clips that I got from the A6400.
Okay. It's supposed to rain at 9, so that means I need to get some winter drone shots in right now. Like, no time to waste. Gods of me and you, we anywheres for to find ourselves some truth. Oh, what you waiting for? No, what you waiting for? We counted all our reasons, excuses that we made. We found ourselves some treasure and threw it all away. Oh, what you waiting for? No, what you waiting for? That just got so close to the house.
Yeah, yeah, get it going.
Wait, are you vlogging today?
Girl, I'm vlogging every day. The sun's beating down, blame
it all. Patrick drove me because I don't know how to drive in the snow. But I'm going ice skating because I'm going to be a figure skater. Alexa, play Heavy Hitter by Jack Harlow. Bye.
Okay, tell me what the deal is. You know I'm the illest. She from California, says she don't know what
the deal is. I just wanted to take a moment. Like, let's take a look at the yard real quick. You know, everybody hates on winter. But then,
it looks like this. Come on! It's beautiful.
This right here is gonna be a skating rink. for my sister. She figure skates.
Gonna be a figure skater.
But over there is the pond. It's just like when January rolls around, it gets really hard to maintain the ice. So this is a bit smaller and, you know, easy to maintain. While I'm out here, I'm gonna get some cinematic-y shots with this camera, and then you guys can take a look at the footage, see if you like it. But everything looks nice, so this shouldn't be that hard, but let's see what I can do.
Since the flood. Oh, Ophelia, heaven help a fool who falls in love. I got a little paycheck. You got a big plan, and you gotta move. And
I'm sorry, buddy.
He was eating.
Hey, buddy. Watch Murphy's reaction when I ask him this question.
Murphy, hey, do you want to go on a walk? Do you want to go on a walk? He knows. He's going to the door. Okay, I'll be right there, okay?
He knows, I'm telling you, he knows. He's probably out of food.
So we just crushed a walk in the woods with Murphy, one of my favorite things. But to make this day complete, I need to do another one of my favorite things, and that is skateboarding. However, you can see that it's snowing outside today. And in Maine, when winter comes around, I can't skateboard as often. So I picked up an Ambition snow skate so I can do some type of skateboarding in the winter. I'm not that good at snow skating yet, but you've probably seen the guys who can. So I think today I'm just gonna try and kickflip down this porch. I have like an inch of wet snow, so I'll see if this works, but...
I'm counting it.